Hi everyone, thanks for checking out video number 3. I hope this message reaches you and your loved ones safe and well. So I mentioned in the last video that I would be talking about the different safety precautions as well as the technology that's available to us as agents and therefore to you as buyers and sellers to continue to buy and sell homes in this market. So the first thing I thought I'd share is that we're seeing some promising patterns in other states that have started lifting some of the restrictions. And one of those things in terms of real estate has been that we've seen tons of homes come on the market in those states. So that's a promising pattern that hopefully we will also see in New Jersey. Of course, we've been more affected than most states, so we have to take those precautions and make sure that when we do those things and lift those restrictions, we are ready for that. But it's helpful to know that other states are seeing that positive growth and opportunities in real estate. Now, on the same token, I thought it'd be important to kind of offer something to think about as a potential seller in this market. So for you, if you're thinking about selling and you're saying, oh, well, that's great, I'll put my home on the market at that time and everyone else will too. So what does that mean? You're going to have more competition, right? So while we have the safety precautions in place and while we have the technology in place, there are some ways that you would benefit from putting your home on the market now. You might attract a really great buyer and not be amongst a lot of other competition. So keep that in mind. All right, so getting into our safety precautions, we have a hold harmless clause, which is, as it states, the requirement to sign that you are going to hold harmless any of the other parties should you or someone you're with become sick or ill. And the same is true for the sellers. So both parties have to sign. And you're also stating that you have not been sick in the last 14 days, as well as you have not been around anyone who has been sick in the last 14 days. It's important to have that in place. We're also wearing gloves and a mask no matter where we go when we're showing homes. So I just showed a few homes the other day. And we all had our gloves, we all had a mask, and I was the only one touching anything like the doorknobs and the light switches. So limiting that really helps. We also have maximum numbers of people who can go into a home and tour a home at one time in person, which is important as well, right? Limiting the number of people in a space obviously protects us all. So just some things that I think are really helpful in terms of the safety that we're putting in place for you and for everyone. The exciting technology pieces that I'm really hoping stick with us in this industry are some of the virtual tours. So we have different kinds of virtual tours, and I just thought I'd go through them with you. We have live with the agent. So if I was your agent, I'd be calling you on FaceTime and walking through the home. And this way you can ask questions or ask me to zoom in or go back to another room right there and then. Then we have virtual tours on the MLS. So professional companies going in and doing a video, editing it, and then having the agent upload it to the MLS so that you can watch that online on your own time and decide if you wanted to go in person. And we have live virtual tours, which are open houses usually, in which case the agent who's listing the property is showing the property all at once to whoever wants to jump on that live call, that live video. And you can ask questions right there and then that the agent can then answer right there and then, which is really, I think, a great tool as well. And lastly, we have something called a Matterport, which is basically a 3D virtual tour where you can tour the home at your own will. Maybe you walk in the house and you wanna go upstairs. Maybe you wanna go to the left or the right. And those are things you get to choose on that Matterport tour. So it's similar to if you've been on Google and you walk the neighborhood and you can kind of pick and choose which way you go with those arrows. It's the same idea. It's a super great tool. I'm super excited about it. And I hope you take advantage of some of these things. As I said, feel free to ask any questions. Hope you're all staying safe and talk to you soon. Bye-bye.